In 1964, Gary Flandreau of the Jet Propulsion Laboratory discovered that the outer planets would align in the late 1970s, creating a unique opportunity for a spacecraft to visit all of them using gravity assists. The Voyager probes seized this rare chance, becoming the first and only probes to venture into interstellar space to this day. However, that particular alignment occurs once every 175 years. Does this mean we won't see another mission like the Voyager probes in our lifetime? In the late 1970s, the United States and the Soviet Union were in the midst of the Cold War, and just a few years after the height of the space race when Neil Armstrong set foot on the moon. This provided a unique opportunity where ambitious space projects were backed by substantial government funding. The political situation of the era created a sense of urgency and priority for space missions like the Voyager program. The program was aimed not just to study individual planets, but to go on a grand tour of the outer solar system. This is a drastic contrast to today's more focused, scientifically driven space exploration. In addition to scientific instruments, they also contained a golden record, which carries greetings in 55 languages, sounds of Earth from thunderstorms to kisses, and a curated selection of music from various cultures. This, I am pretty sure, won't appear on a NASA space probe anytime soon. But today's space exploration landscape looks noticeably different. International collaboration has largely replaced Cold War competition. Budget constraints and changing priorities have shifted focus towards more targeted missions. The era of grand, sweeping explorations like Voyager seems to have passed, especially considering how it was able to reach interstellar space in the first place. The Voyager missions utilized a method known as gravitational slingshot. This technique allowed Voyager 1 to gain speed and alter its trajectory by passing close to massive planets. Imagine a spacecraft approaching a planet. As it nears, the planet's gravity pulls the craft closer, accelerating it. If the trajectory is carefully calculated, the spacecraft can swing around the planet and be flung outward at a higher speed, without using any of its own fuel. This is precisely what Voyager 1 did as it swept past Jupiter in 1979, using the gas giant's tremendous gravity to catapult itself towards Saturn and beyond. This was only possible due to a rare planetary alignment that occurs every 175 years, where the outer planets pass the same point in their orbits simultaneously, appearing from Earth's perspective to line up in a roughly straight line. This gravitational assist was able to unlock the outer solar system. Without it, a mission to explore multiple outer planets would have been incredibly expensive and time-consuming. The slingshot effect allowed Voyager 1 to accomplish in years what might have otherwise taken decades. And in those years, Voyager 1 made several groundbreaking discoveries. It revealed that Jupiter has hundreds of hurricanes swirling in its atmosphere. And perhaps most surprisingly at the time, it found that Io, one of Jupiter's moons, is the most volcanically active body in our entire solar system. Even the Voyager program's co-investigator, Alan Cummings, was shocked. At first, he thought someone had sent them a picture of a badly made pizza instead of the real image of Io's surface. But Voyager 1's journey didn't end at Jupiter or Saturn. In 1998, it surpassed Pioneer 10 to become the farthest human-made object in space. Then, in 2012, it achieved something unprecedented. It crossed into interstellar space, becoming the first human-made object to leave the bubble of our sun's influence and enter the vast unknown between stars. Even now, over four decades after its launch, Voyager 1 continues to send valuable data back to Earth. Its instruments are providing us with unprecedented information about the interstellar medium, which is the space between star systems. The scale of Voyager's achievement is incomprehensible. NASA's Voyager missions collectively required over 10,000 work years and represent one of the greatest explorations in human history. But will we ever see anything like it again, preferably within the next 175 years? Today's space missions have moved away from the wide-ranging explorations that defined the Voyager era. Instead, they focus on targeted objectives, often honing in on specific planets or moons. This shift reflects a change in scientific approach, prioritizing depth over breadth. But what drives these new missions? One key factor is the evolution of space technology. Today's instruments are capable of continuous data collection over extended periods, which is vastly different from Voyager's brief planetary encounters. This advancement has led to a preference for missions that can orbit a celestial body for years, gathering detailed information that was once unattainable. However, technological progress comes at a price. The cost of modern space missions has skyrocketed, placing significant constraints on what can be achieved. For instance, the proposed Europa Clipper mission, designed to study Jupiter's icy moon, is projected to cost around $5 billion. This figure dwarfs the relatively modest budget of $865 million for both Voyager probes. In response to that price, space agencies have now turned to international collaboration. This approach allows for shared resources and expertise, but it also impacts mission priorities. Collaborative projects often focus on specific scientific questions rather than broad exploratory missions, reflecting the diverse interests of multiple stakeholders. The change in mission design is also influenced by our evolving understanding of the solar system. Voyager's grand tour was made possible by a rare planetary alignment, a cosmic opportunity that won't recur until the mid-22nd century. Modern missions, lacking this advantage, must chart more direct courses to their destinations, limiting the possibility of multi-planet flybys. In addition, if we did want to explore interstellar space and explore other star systems, we don't have the technology to do so. But there is optimism. We have the technology to surpass Voyager 1 if we choose to. Nuclear fusion offers 1,000 times the power of the conventional ion thrusters currently used in orbit. If we were to send a space probe powered by nuclear fusion traveling at 500,000 miles per hour, it would catch up to Voyager 1 at its current distance in about 3.5 years. So, while the unique circumstances that enabled Voyager's grand tour are unlikely to align again soon, we are definitely capable of launching another probe that could surpass Voyager 1 within 1 or 2 decades. Even more fascinating, with our current technology, we might witness humans exploring Mars and potentially even the moons of Saturn within our lifetime.